to the E to the L to the U to the X to the E to the top. Well, hello there guys, it is Qwerty Afro here. I'm bringing you another OMSI 2 video. Today, I'm going to be back on Berlin X10, and I know you guys have been loving my video on the South London project. I promise I'll bring out a few more, because obviously there's the Volvo Gemini 2 bus and also the Enviro 200 that are drivable now, I do believe, so I'll try and get some more videos of those out soon. Upload schedule will be a bit, you know, on the slow side because obviously I have loads of uni work to be doing, but I'll try my best to get bits of uploads up when I can. I'm back on Berlin X10 as you, well, you can't really tell, there could be any map for you right now on, but I'm on Berlin X10 and I'm going to be doing another route. We've already covered line X10, but I'm going to go a little bit on the outskirts, I do believe, because obviously we're not in the BVG livery. We're going to be looking at this relatively new bus that's been added into OMSI 2, and it's actually free to download as well. It is the MAN Euro 6 Lion City single floor bus, and it's been modelled and made by Vengeance 3D Design. He's done an absolutely great job of this bus, and you may think, well, this looks pretty much the same as the previous Lion City single floor bus, if you know how it already looks like. It's totally similar. There's nothing too different with this bus in terms of visuals. Like, the main thing, and I kind of dig this, is it's these kind of three little windows here that are just like at knee level height. So essentially, if we go in here and change the camera, if I can get a good camera. No, that's not a good camera. This is a good camera. Essentially, babies from prams and stuff like that can just look outside and get a view now. So basically, whoever designed this new kind of like facelifted or kind of, you know, slightly upgraded version of the current Lion City single floor bus, they've pretty much catered for the toddlers, for the babies that are in prams, because they can now have a view outside and look at the passing traffic or whatever. So I don't know, I think it looks pretty cool. I like this addition to it. It makes the bus look a little bit bigger, a little bit more airy inside, and then from the outside it just looks like you can see more of the inside, so it's kind of made it look a little bit more bigger. I do believe the bus is slightly more bigger than the predecessor. Other than that, oh, some S-bonds going on there, double decker goodness. Other than that, like at the front here, you can see that there's two kind of new fog lights next to the, on the left and the right of the QA registration plate. The lights themselves are slightly different, but obviously they're the kind of same design lights. Backlights are pretty much the same as well, but you can see that it's generally the same type of model. I think they probably kept with this kind of same kind of design in real life, as well as obviously in the game. It's because it's a good kind of working bus. So I think these are pretty popular buses all around Europe, and if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Wait, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Yeah, I got the saying right. Another thing that's actually different is also the passenger doors are no longer the kind of enclosed kind of opening and closing doors. They are actually pop out double leaf doors, which is pretty good, and we'll see them in action once we get on the way. But other than that, I don't think there's anything too different. Inside is slightly more modernized, but it pretty much was always modernized in this kind of model of bus, to be honest. Up here we have the nice kind of like display information, which actually runs with the Berlin X10 kind of routes and stuff like that, which we'll get set up in a moment. But other than that, I think inside it's pretty much like probably slightly different layout, maybe nothing too different. It's a bit more roomy in here. Apparently, it's, as I said, it's slightly bigger than the predecessor. But other than that, it's a pretty good bus and I like it. And that's why I wanted to do actually a video of it for you guys, because it's just come out now on beta 1.2. It's not even a fully released bus. Yeah, but Vengeance 3D Design has been doing it, and he's still developing for it, and he will update the bus over through time once it gets more updates and stuff like that. So, and it's free as well, so if you want to go get it, the link to stuff will be down below to his Facebook page where you can download it. And there you go, another MAN bus to add to your catalogue of OMSI buses. Other than that, we're going to be doing route or line, I kind of say route for British buses, and then everything else I kind of use line, so that's the kind of differentiation I use there. So we're going to be doing line 601 today, and we're going to be doing it in, because I don't know what HavelBus is. Like, I know it's another bus company, but I guess it's the kind of bus company for the outskirts of Berlin, I'm assuming. Correct me if I'm wrong, because you have the normal BVG, which is for the inner Berlin and the kind of center in the city. I don't even know if HavelBus even go inside to the city of Berlin or whatever, but I'm kind of going on the assumptions that HavelBus is the carrier or the company that does kind of these outskirts, because right now we're technically on the outskirts of Germany. I mean, not Germany, Berlin. And they have this kind of blue and white, and that's why I've been seeing them all around when you go, like with the BVG routes, like the X10, when we were going outside of Berlin, we saw these kind of blue and white ones, and they're actually drivable routes. So today we're going to be doing 601 in this lovely bus, which it does come with the HavelBus livery. It also comes with BVG and some other ones, and you can play on like quite of most of the German kind of routes and maps and stuff like that. And I think more kind of HOF files and stuff will be added in the future, so you can play this bus on more maps. But anyway, 601, as you can see behind us, is a articulated bendy bus of X1, which is actually in a way the same route as line 601, which we're doing. But the X1 is the express service, and we are actually the normal service that stops at pretty much every stop, while X1 just does a few stops and then gets to its destination a lot quicker. But other than that, let's get set up. Lovely cabin in here as well, just to point out. Some things obviously aren't fully gold quality in terms of texturing and stuff. Like, you can see stuff here, like on the doors, it isn't fully clear, whatever. But to be honest, it's been done by one guy, and I'm pretty impressed with overall. The sounds and stuff like that are gorgeous, and overall, I love the look of this bus. I love these three little windows. They're just great. Anyway, I have a schedule here. Let's stop rambling, Samuel. We have to leave at 12:38, and I do believe it is 12:15 now, so we're going to have to speed up time a little bit. But other than that, there's nothing really too much to show you around the cabin. I don't even think this thing can open the actual cabin door and stuff, so it's not a fully complete bus. It is in beta 1.2, as I've said. But other than that, pretty good. Pretty standard MAN cabin. Everything pretty much is where you expect it for an MAN. And let's get on. Let's get the electrics on. Shouts, which before I forget to do them, go to RedBadger123 and the Enderman. That's again RedBadger123 and the Enderman. Their links and stuff will be down below. And as well, the special shout out to Vengeance3D Design for actually making this bus. And his link to his Facebook page where you can download the bus will be down below as well. So, electrics are on. We can turn on the bus. I'll go outside. I want to hear the roar. Very nice. Very nice. Give it a little bit of rev. That is very nice. Right, let's set up a few things. I'm going to actually turn on the lights because it is a bit of a dreary day. I put it on real weather, so this is essentially Berlin right now. Right now when I'm recording. It's right now I'm recording in the night, even though it's the day. So it's technically the actual weather right now in the night, but shown throughout the day. So let's set up our route and stuff. So like our destination board right now is blank. I found out that you actually, the IBS system, which I found out before when I did the X10 video on line X10 in the double-decker line city, I thought that there was actually no IBS system or like computer, but actually people have been telling me that the IBS system is within the ticket machine. And then I read up in the manual, which I was supposed to do, and yeah, I found all the codes and stuff, so now I know to get the kind of announcements working and also the codes and stuff. So you to get the codes and stuff working, you press this button, Storno LSK, and if we do press that, get that up, and basically we have four things essentially to type in. We have the LLL, the triple L or whatever. That's the R line, so our line is 601. SS is for special character. If we had like X or Z or whatever, or M in our route number or line number. And because we don't have any, we're just going to keep it zero. I don't actually know what KK is for. But normally on pretty much everything with Berlin X10, it's remain 0. And then triple R is for the route number, and I do believe our run is 004. And then that should be fine. And then if I press enter again, it will get it to bound alpha. I'll just press it again. And then if I clear my steering wheel here, we can press Q. And that hopefully should get that, which now shows our destination, which is 601 to Potsdam Hauptbahnhof, if I'm pronouncing that correctly. But you know me with my German videos, I do not pronounce anything correctly. So we're going to be going to, and the last stop here on our timetable, it says is Waldschanke, if I'm saying that right. Waldschanke, number 2, terminus. And that's all good. And if I go back here onto this camera, we can actually see that the destination display board here inside the bus, it works, and that will change as well automatically, so passengers can see where we're going. Other than that, I do believe all we just have to do is turn on the lights, and I think we're ready to go. I just need to fast forward time to about 12:37, so we can just, you know, be on time and not like massively early. And also turn on the directions, because you know me and my directions, it just doesn't work. And we can now basically essentially put the bus in drive, release the handbrake, and off we go. People are saying that I don't use my mirrors. I'm going to use my mirrors now. There's a car coming from there, but I'm just going to make it. I'm going to hopefully make this. There we go. Oof. There we go. Welcome on board, everyone. Welcome aboard. Line 601. And let's head off. You have to always put the station brake on, so there we go. And the actual bus like subsides down, just, you know, for disabled access or whatever, and it does that all the time when you put the station brake on. And it can take a bit of a while to, you know, get back up and go, so you can't, like on most other buses, you can just open the front doors and just go, essentially, stop and go. While with this, you have to put the station brake on and let the bus subside and then rise up again when you close the doors or whatever. So it's a bit slow, but I like it. You know, it's the dynamics of the bus. What's this Renault again doing? Oh, no. Right, hazard lights on. We're going to do this the efficient way. We're going to call the police. And it took 8 minutes off our journey. That's a shame. But, you know, I did the right thing there. That was my fault. That was no one else's fault but my fault. I just didn't brake in time. It really is a miserable day. Okay, one thing I've actually forgot to put on is actually the wipers. And I need to show you guys the pop-out passenger doors, the exit doors. Once we get somewhere where we can let off passengers. One thing I actually need to do, I need to press again, because it doesn't seem that it's registered. I need to press the, I think the Q again. There we go. You have to press Q again on that, on the dashboard, so it just registers that we're changing stops and stuff like that, or it will stay at one stop's name. So now this is Blumenstrasse. There we go. Something in my throat right there. Right. Station brake off. And let's let her go. One thing I want to talk to you guys about, and brace yourselves, it's not going to be something totally positive, but don't take it the wrong way. I've been noticing on my YouTube channel, like, because I like to look at... Okay, guys. Okay, German passengers. Okay. Okay. Okay! Wow, Jesus Christ. What I did was, like, clip the curb there a little bit. Nothing too serious. Anyway, what I want to talk about. I've been looking at my analytics, as I do, and I love to look at analytics. I'm just that type of person that just loves looking at numbers and stuff like that, and not necessarily to maximize stuff or whatever, but just I just like looking at numbers and just seeing what things are doing in terms of like what a video does once I release it, and like what like is popular this month or whatever, etc. And I like looking at my analytics, and to be honest, I would, if anyone runs a YouTube channel or whatever, I would highly encourage it. It's even if you're not so good with like data and stuff like that, it's just well, YouTube makes it very easy to kind of like digest of like what's going on and like where are you getting like the most attention or whatever off of what video or whatever. And it's a very nice little thing to look at, and I look at it quite a lot because I love looking at analytics and stuff and data and stuff like that, because it's, I don't know, I'm just weird like that. But one thing, apologize for the coughing, one thing I've been realizing, oh Jesus, there's quite a lot of people here. One thing I've been realizing recently, and I'm not saying, like, I don't know if I'm saying anything, but one thing I've been realizing is that I basically am getting a lot of attention and stuff on my train sim and on my OMSI 2 content, which is great, and that's like probably the two most known games that I'm known for my channel. It used to be Cities of Motion 2 when I used to do a huge like Let's Play series of that back in the day when I did that, and that was the first game that really got my channel noticed. And then when I started doing train sim, new viewers came in that wanted to, you know, watch just basically for train sim. And then when I started OMSI, people like coming to my channel to watch OMSI as well. So OMSI and train sim have become like the two kind of main kind of games that people love to come and watch me. I just have a sip of water there. My throat is really acting up. I kind of find when I'm recording, either my nose goes blocked, or it feels like there's something in my throat, and I kind of can't speak at certain times. And I find it's always when I'm recording, and it's weird. I think it's because when you use your voice a lot at one go, your voice then starts to, you know, that's when your voice can start to like break down or whatever. But if you're using your voice passively or whatever, like, you know, every day when you talk to your friends or you go somewhere and you talk, you don't really realize it. But when you're actually focused on just using your voice like I am with this commentary, then I feel like my voice just acts up. But anyway, not the main point. So I get basically most of my attention with my channel on OMSI 2 and train sim, and I think that's fair to say. I think everyone could pretty much agree on that, and basically the numbers don't lie. So if someone doesn't agree on that, then basically numbers don't lie. My point I want to make here, and I don't want anyone to get, like, you know, a bit frustrated if I come across as a bit like mean when I say this. But anyway, no, I'm not being mean. I'm not being mean at all. I'm not being mean. But I've been realizing, like, recently that other videos and stuff that I do that may not be OMSI 2 or train sim related are kind of starting to really just not get any kind of traction or any kind of like response in a way to how like my train sim or OMSI 2 content gets like reacted to when like as soon as I upload it. Like for example, when I uploaded recent train sim videos, I just get like floods of comments straight away within the first hour of people like, you know, coming and telling me, oh yeah, it's a great video or whatever, whatever. And that's great. And it's the same with OMSI. OMSI and train sim just have that effect where once it's uploaded, everyone is straight watching it, commenting on it, wants to know what I'm doing in it or whatever. And that's great. But then when I come to these kind of when I come to other kind of games, like, I don't know, say Transocean, which is my kind of, like, if I had to look in terms of now what I'm doing differently in terms of not doing Train Sim or OMSI 2, Transocean is pretty much a series right now I'm doing that's not Train Sim or OMSI. But one thing I've been finding is that these other kind of videos that I do of other games do not get, like, at all the same kind of reaction that my kind of Train Sim or OMSI 2 videos get. And I'm a bit sad by that because, like, every single video, whether it's Train Sim or OMSI or not, gets the kind of same treatment. It takes the same amount of, like, you know, time and effort to make. And I feel like when I watch, when I see, like, when, like, my analytics and stuff where, like, Train Sim and OMSI are getting all that kind of attention, I feel like, you know, why can't, like, say something like Transocean get a lot of attention? Or, like, you know, like, say when I did Star Wars Battlefront, when I tried it for my QWERTY Try series. And, you know, because I have the numbers. I have, like, the amount of people that watch my videos. That's not the problem. But the thing is, the problem that people seem not to be watching it. Like those kind of other things, they only just seem to stick around for Train Sim and OMSI 2. Are you going to let me go? Are you going to let me? Okay, thank you. That lorry truck driver just wasn't so sure there. Oh god, roundabouts, I hate them. In this game. And in real life, to be honest, they're horrible in real life. But where am I getting at with this? So, like, just other stuff, like the Star Wars game that I did, like the QWERTY Try Star Wars Battlefront. Like, I understand that everyone here is probably not, like, friends with FPS shooters or whatever. I get that. And, you know, other things, like, there's been, just been other games and stuff like that just don't get as much traction as Train Sim and OMSI. And I don't know, I wonder why. It can't just be people don't like that certain game or they're not interested in that sort of game. Because I honestly hope that like this kind of channel that I'm kind of building up in a sense is a channel where people are subscribed to me because of like say my personality and my kind of flavor of making commentary videos for like the certain types of games that I play. And I would definitely say at the beginning of my kind of career on YouTube, like, the primary thing of the video was probably more the game, and probably people were subscribing to me more for the game than myself. And I think it's now slowly turning around where people are subscribing for me rather than the game, or more like the game and me. But I don't know. It's an interesting one. I'm a bit sad about it because obviously it in a way it lowers my confidence of like trying out new things and stuff like that because if I see that not many people are bothered to, you know, watch some of my other stuff like the Transocean playthrough, it just like lowers my confidence to do other things with other games in the future or whatever. And the thing is, like, I'll always be doing Train Sim and OMSI, but it's sad to think that that's the only thing that people are so interested of me for. But I don't know. That's just, like, a bit of an issue. Well, not an issue, but just a bit of a kind of thought I've been having recently, because after looking at, like, analytics and stuff like that. I don't want it to sound like patronizing or whatever, or like I'm just like, oh no, Qwerty's saying this because he doesn't like what's happening or whatever, blah blah blah. I'm just saying it because it's just something I've noticed, and you know, I just wanted to raise the thought. And in a way, what I would want from you guys, if there's anything I would want from you guys, is, you know, maybe give some of these other videos and stuff like a try, you know, just show them more support, like you showed the Train Sim videos and the OMSI 2 videos, the amount of support and love that you guys give it. And I know that there's loads of people that watch those kind of other stuff, those kind of niche stuff that I do, like with Transocean or any other kind of game that I will be doing. Like, I want to bring back Mini Metro, because I haven't actually done a video of Mini Metro in quite some time, and by, like, since the last one, the game's, like, fully released now, it's a full game, and it has, like, audio and stuff in it. And I really want to do that, but I'm scared that I might, you know, continue Mini Metro, like, on what I think we're on episode 4. I don't want to continue and upload episode 4, and then, like, you know, only, like, 50% of normal viewership, you know, watches it. Because then it will, then I'll kind of feel that, like, you know, that's maybe no longer kind of a thing of interest on my channel, while before it was a, you know, a bigger, much bigger interest. Like, same with Transocean. I remember when I know it's weird to think, like, like, I feel that this thing is really recent. Right, just nicely park up here. I feel that it's a bit recent because, like, say when I've uploaded Train Sim and OMSI kind of videos, and I've seen that straight away it gets, like, huge, like, numbers coming in where people are just commenting and, like, you know, reacting to it or whatever. But then when I upload, like, a Transocean video, it doesn't get the same kind of response, and that, I don't know, it just makes me think a bit, like, why is it that, why is that, or, I don't know. But anyway, that's just a little thought I've had, and I don't want it to, like, it pretty much has drowned the whole video in that, but it's something I wanted to talk to you guys about, and, you know, just get your opinions off. And in a way, raise the concern I've had. But, you know, if that's how it's going to be, that's gonna how it's going to be. I thank everyone that watches my Train Sim and OMSI videos, and then I thank all the kind of, like, you know, the small bit, like, the small few of you who watch, like, things other than Train Sim and OMSI. But I hope it gets better. I hope it gets how it was before, where, like, I noticed, like, at the beginning of this year, it was, like, a more kind of balanced playing field where, like, equal amounts of people watching Train Sim and OMSI and all the other kind of other stuff I was doing. But that's my issue there. We can put it to rest now. If you want to comment about it and tell me your thoughts about it, please do. I'd love to hear it. Right, we have joined here the main road with all the main buses or whatever. Let's just let all these people out. X1's right in front of us. I don't know why it's standing there, it just has its front door open. Let's have a look here. Ah, it's early, that's why. You can see here on the countdown it's supposed to be, like, here in 1 minute, so it's probably waiting here to clear its time or whatever. But yeah, it's going to the same destination we are, so right now we're gonna just nicely overtake it and get there before it does. There we go. Come on, turn. Sometimes the steering wheel turns fast and sometimes it doesn't. But anyway, this route, I find it intertwines and interlinks between loads of these. Like, it joins with X10 a bit, it joins with 625 and loads of other buses and whatever. It's really nice. I like this kind of route. A lot of variation in terms of, like, it goes a bit suburban and a bit urban, and then, you know, it's very nice. go. Nice map over there of the whole network. I don't know if that's just of HavelBus's network or if that's like the whole kind of BVG and HavelBus and everything essentially in Berlin or whatever. Would be pretty cool to think it would be that. Right, off we go. Is that camp? Nope, that's not gonna. That hit the hippie van isn't gonna let us through this time. Oh, and another roundabout. Oh, I had to brake there. I didn't want to call the police again. Right. Oh, these roundabouts. Oh, and I made it clear. Nice. I'm a half master of roundabouts in OMSI 2. Nicely does it here. Most people are probably getting off because of that braking I did behind the hippie bus. Oh no, actually not a lot of people are getting off. I'm very surprised about that. I do love these sliding door animations. They're really well done. We go, just continuing straight. I do love this, like the water sprinkles from the cars. Like, I have not even realized that too much. You know, I only realized it in this actual recording of this video. That's just me, like, not noticing like things of OMSI. Because you think, like, when you look at OMSI, you'd think it's just like a. It's a very basic game. It's not too, like, you know, it's not, doesn't have a very good graphics engine, but actually, to be honest, it has a nice little competent one that does, like, you know, haven't closed that. There we go. It has quite a good graphics engine for its time, to be honest, because it simulates very well, in a sense, and I think that's what keeps it still relevant, I assume. That it simulates, like, buses very well, and even though it's not going to look like, I don't know, like, what's a really good-looking game these days. Like, it's not going to look like Euro Truck, but I definitely feel that OMSI has a higher simulation kind of feel to the game than Euro Truck does and probably will ever have. And it's going to be really interesting to see what the new project of Lotus Simulation is from the current makers of OMSI. That's their kind of mega kind of simulator thing where they're going to incorporate metro subway, bus, tram, and I think that's it. But it's going to be really interesting to see what they do in their next project, because hopefully if they can keep the kind of same simulation feel of like what OMSI was and hopefully will still be, if they keep that kind of same kind of simulation kind of feel and then just make better graphics, it could be on to a really good winner for a simulation game of the future. Another bus lane for me. Oh, it's not. It doesn't even last that long. And only one person getting off. Lovely sliding doors. Love it. Try and drive a bit in the interior camera, but that never goes well. Ooh, I nearly clipped that car. Nearly. Ah, and an annoying red traffic light. And there's no cars coming through that junction, so just pointless all us waiting here. Come on, let's move on, guys. We have places to go, people to see. A nice final right here. I think we're very close to the actual destination point. Ah, yes, there it is. Wild Shanker. Nice little bus station here. Well, I think quite a few lines converge and terminate here. 626, 601, X1, 62, 62. I think that's it, actually. I think I said that most of them. And then you have like the night buses and stuff like that. There we go. A little too close to the curb, but essentially okay, but then we basically made it late because of that little car incident where we had to call the police, but if we didn't have that, we probably would have been all good. But there we go. That's 623, 620. Oh, so you have also bus lines that actually just go through this bus station, they don't terminate here. So if I go here, we can see that, look, I'm on the board. We're here, we're ready to terminate. Oh no, this is actually, this is for the return trip to Telltale Bahnhof. Ah. But we're not going to be doing that trip in this video. Essentially, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I hope you enjoyed the MAN Euro 6 Lion City single 4 bus by Vengeance 3D Design. The link to his Facebook page where you can then follow links to download this bus will be in the description below. Tell me what you think about this bus. If you've downloaded it yourself and had a play of it, tell me your thoughts. Do you like the design? I really do like these three little, you know, toddler windows, as I'm calling them. I think the sounds are really nice, and so far the interior and the exterior are pretty good. And hopefully it'll just get better with updates and stuff like that, as it is in beta. And essentially that is pretty much their wrap up. I hope you enjoyed Lion 601. Very nice route to drive. I definitely would recommend it. And if you want something with a lot of stops, but if you want basically the same kind of route I did but with less stops, then try X1. That's definitely gonna cater to your needs if you don't want that many stops. Other than that, that was some more X10. I'll definitely be getting to do some more X10, Berlin X10 videos in the future. Definitely, because there's quite a lot of stuff to get through. Probably the next one will be going back to doing a BVG kind of route, and then maybe coming back then to do another HavelBus route. We'll see. And then obviously, the South London project, I'll definitely get on to do a few more videos of those. I did some train sim in the mix there. Also, Vienna 23A and 24A have come out on Aerosoft and also on Steam. I was wondering, is there any point of actually getting those? I would love to get them because they look pretty cool. The buses and stuff that come with them look pretty nice. Is there any point of getting them? Would you guys love to see me cover a video with Vienna 23A, 24A? Do I have to have the normal Vienna map to play those two DLCs, or do you just buy those DLCs each and then you just get the Vienna map with them or whatever? Tell me down below. I would love to know, because I would love to cover that route, hopefully, eventually. But it's quite a lot, actually. They're quite expensive DLCs. But if there's the interest there, I'll definitely probably do a video of it or whatever in the future. But other than that, I'm going to take this bus off. I'm going to give it to the AI. I'm going to go on to FreeCam and watch that Euro 6 go. You can see here another 62. Is that 627? Yeah, 627. It's just pulled in there. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoy that. That was the Euro 6 Euro 6 Lion City MAM bus, Singapore bus, by Vengeance 3D Design, and this was Berlin X10 again on Route 601, Line 601. Hope you guys enjoyed it. The shoutouts again go to RedBadger123 and the Enderman. That's again RedBadger123 and the Enderman. Their links and stuff will be down below. Again, I hope you've enjoyed it, and hopefully I'll see more of you on like other videos, except for OMSI and Train Sim, as if you've listened to the kind of discussion I've had during this whole video. It'd be cool to see more of you, like, you know, reacting and commenting on all the kind of other videos that I do that are not Train Sim and OMSI. But if you don't want to watch those other ones, then fine, I can't force you to, but it's just something that I've kind of noticed, and you know, it would be nice to have more people, you know, react in the same kind of way that, you know, people react on an OMSI or a Train Sim video on other videos. But, you know, it's not a win-win situation here. You can't have everything, as they say. But thank you guys for watching, and it's great that loads of people still stick around to watch me, even though I've kind of lowered the kind of upload activity due to my uni work. But it's really nice to see that there's still people out there that want to watch my content, and if there is still that kind of, like, you know, interest, I'll be there to make some content for you guys. And I enjoy doing it, so it's a nice pastime. Anyway, guys, I hope to see you in another video very soon, and on that, have a good day. I'll catch you next time. Bye, guys. We ain't never giving up, 'cause we ain't born for that. Gotta catch up fast, you do.